Okay, welcome all. Myself Vinayak Kulkarni. Today we will start a lecture series on mathematical logic. Okay, so we will move ahead with that. First of all, contents of the today's lecture. Here we will understand first introduction to mathematical logic, then logical connectives, and the last is truth tables. So we will see it one by one. So here, first of all, we have to understand what is meaning of logic. Okay, so if you consider any kind of problem in computer science engineering related to programming, first we will build a logic of that particular problem, and then we will solve that particular problem, and then we will implement that problem. Okay, so here if I want to calculate a factorial of any number, for example, on the screen I have written 5 factorial, then I must know how to calculate the factorial. Then after, whenever I will know the procedure to calculate the factorial of a number, then I will convert that into some specific conventional language. So that is called as logic. Okay, so logic is the main building block of any programming language. Okay, so here, how can I specify the logic here? So to specify logic, I need some standard language. Okay, there are two ways I can specify the logic: by using English language, that is the natural language, and also by using an object language. Okay, so in case of natural language, there can be the problems of syntax. Okay, in case of natural language, there can be the problems of syntax, there can be the problems like error. Okay, one statement can have the two meanings, but in case of object language, the syntax is fixed, so there will be only one meaning for a particular statement. Okay, so here we will use object language to specify a logic. So here we will understand some of the basic elements of object language. So first is statement or prepositions. So statement is also called as prepositions, and mathematical logic is also called as prepositional logic. So object language contains a set of statements. A statement is a declarative sentence. Okay, for a declarative sentence, we can assign a truth value, that is, either we can assign a true or false. Okay, for example, in this case, for each of these sentence, India is our country, we can assign true. Mumbai is capital of Maharashtra, we can assign true. 1 + 2 is equal to 3, we can assign true 3. And Mumbai is in Karnataka, we can assign here false. So for each of these four examples here, either we can assign a value as a true or a value as a false. So this kind of statement is called as declarative sentence, or it is also called as statement, declarative sentence and statement. So next we will understand the types of statement. Basically, there are two types of statement. First is primitive statement, second is compound statement. Primitive statement is also called as atomic statement, and it is generally denoted by the capital letters or alphabets like P, Q, R. There is example given, P is equal to Mumbai is capital of Maharashtra. Okay, so here the example is given. Next, the compound statement. It is also called as molecular statement. Compound statements are formed by using the primitive statement and the combination of logical connectives. So here I will join the two primitive statements by using some logical connectives. So what is meaning of logical connective here? Logical connective is a connecting word which connects two primitive statements. So here I want to join the two primitive statements with some meaningful way. Okay, so I am going to use the concept of logical connective. So here basically there are 5 connectives. In that, first is negation. Negation of a statement is generally formed by introducing the word not or the phrase it is not the case that. Okay, negation is formed by this way: either I can go for this phrase or either I can go for the word only not. It is denoted by the symbol tilde p. So this symbol is called as tilde, T-I-L-D, not p, in not p, and in some cases it is also denoted like this also, in some cases. So in general we will use this tilde p symbol. So Mumbai is capital of Maharashtra. So here if I want to negate this statement, I have to introduce a not keyword in that particular statement. So Mumbai is not capital of Maharashtra. Okay, so this will be the negation of particular statement. So this shows the truth table for negation. Whenever the value is true, the negation P is F. Whenever the value is F, the negation is T. So here, next under connective is conjunction. So conjunction is denoted by this symbol particular P and Q. It is read as P and Q, and the symbol is like this: P and Q, P conjunction Q. So here this statement shows how to calculate the truth value for conjunction. Whenever P and Q both are having the value, truth value as is true, then only P and Q is true, otherwise it is false. So by using this statement we will form the truth table. By using this statement we will form the truth table. Here P, Q having both are, whenever both are having the truth value as a T, then only the P conjunction Q is true. So here P conjunction Q is shown as true. Whenever, so in all the remaining three cases we are not having both the values as true, so all else are false. So this shows a truth table for conjunction. So next is disjunction. Disjunction of two statements is denoted by this way, and it is read as P or Q. Whenever value of P and Q is F, then P disjunction Q is false, otherwise it is true, otherwise it is true. So here in this case, whenever we have only the combination P false, Q false, then the P disjunction Q is false, otherwise it is true, otherwise it is true. So in both the cases we have observed that the statement shows the unique condition. The statement shows unique condition. In case of conjunction, whenever both the values are true, then only P conjunction Q is true. In case of disjunction, whenever both the values are false, then only P disjunction Q is false. So in this case the statement shows what? That particular statement's given shows only the unique conditions. Shows the unique conditions. So next we have to understand the concept of truth table. So here before understanding the truth table concept, we have seen three examples of truth table. Okay, first is negation, second is conjunction, third is disjunction. So here first we will need to understand the meaning of statement formula. Statement formula is a combination of primitive statement and logical connectives. Okay, so here in this case a P is one statement, one atomic statement or primitive statement, and here we are using a disjunction. So this forms a statement formula. Here in this case P conjunction Q, here in this case negation of P disjunction Q, here it is Q. Okay, so in every case all these are examples of statement formula. And how these formulas are formed? The first component is primitive statement and the second component is logical connectives. Okay, if there are n number of variables, then 2 raised to n combinations are present. So what it means? It means that if we are having the one variable, then we can assign only two values, that is 2 raised to n, either it is true or false. And when we have two variables, then we can assign two variables, then we can assign four combinations of truth values. So its meaning is that, and when we have one variable, we can assign two values. So here we have shown an example of one variable. So whenever I am having one variable only in the formula, I will assign it as a true or false. I will assign it as a true or false. So here it shows how we have assigned the combinations. So first, initially for p, we have assigned both the values as true and both the values as false. So here what it means, how we have assigned, just check this condition. Either pq can be both true, pq can be both false. So this forms the row 1, row 4. Either p is true or q is false. Either p is false, q is true. So here these are the combinations formed, and this shows the truth value of statement formula. So this column shows a truth value of a statement formula. So whenever I will calculate a truth table, I will get one final value. It is called as truth value of statement formula. So table showing all such a combinations of truth values is called truth table of formula. Table showing all such a values of truth values is called as truth table. So next we will solve one example here. P disjunction negation Q. So how to solve this example? We have assigned the values here. Okay. Then we have to calculate negation Q. So how to calculate negation Q? Negation means we have to write it in opposite symbol. So here I will write here F T F T. So I have to solve P or negation Q. So here I have marked P or negation Q. So I will check here. I am getting T F. It is T. Here T T. It is T. Here F F. It is F. And here it is T. So whenever the both the combinations are, whenever the both the combinations are false, then only it is false, otherwise it is true. So we have solved the problem number 1, and this final column will show the truth value of the statement formula. So this whole value will show the truth value of this particular statement formula. So here we are having next example. So I will write here F T. The final answer will be P and negation P. So it will be both the elements will be false. Both the elements will be false. So next example. So here this will show the final statement formula. I will write negation P. Negation P means we have to negate this particular column 1. F T T. Next P or Q. Next is P or Q. So here I will get T T T F. So I will take these two columns. Okay. Next P or Q or negation Q. Okay. So I will take this first column or so here actually it is written here Q, but it is P. So you can take it as negation P. So P or Q or negation P. So by mistake it is written Q. So this is the first column, this is the second column. I will get the answer as T F T T F T T T T F T T. So here I am having no combinations are FF. So I will get all the values as true. In this special condition we can call it as tautology. So whenever I will get, we have concept ahead also, so it is called as tautology. So in this video lecture we have covered the basics of mathematical logic with the three connectives, that is negation, conjunction and disjunction, and also we have covered the truth table concept, and we have also solved some of the examples. Okay, if you like this video, please do subscribe to this channel, also share and also like this video. Thank you.